AMD's Fidelity FX Super Resolution, aka FSR, has been launched, and today's video is going to be on FSR in relation to Dota 2. Because Dota 2 is a game, if you guys didn't know, I've been playing Dota 2 for a long time. It's one of my favorite games in the list of games that I commonly play on PC. So when I saw this technology was available for it, I just knew I had to test it out with not just AMD graphics cards, but also against NVIDIA's graphics cards as well, where AMD in their presentation made a big point that this technology won't just give more FPS to AMD graphics cards, but also NVIDIA graphics cards as well. So what we're going to do now is show you guys some benchmark numbers straight away with an RX 570 at 1080p, as well as 1440p, and also 4K. Now this is on max settings, and in order to enable FSR, you have to lower the screen resolution under that of 100. So it won't enable if you've got your screen resolution set at 100%. But moving over now to the GTX 1660 Ti. This was another card that we decided to throw into the mix here. At 1080p and 1440p with this graphics card, we do get CPU bound at these resolutions. Pretty much like the RX 570 at 1080p. And then at 4K, we do start to see a difference here. But you'll notice that I've shown a few different interesting outliers here, and we'll point to the 1440p graphs in particular, where we decided to throw in a 99% resolution scaling benchmark with NVIDIA's Sharpen filter from their freestyle game filter, which you can enable in Dota 2, and also the FSR, which AMD says it's an upscaling pass as well as a sharpening pass. And so how it exactly works, at least from what I gather and the information I've been told, is it upscales in a linear and non-linear way. So in other words, if I was to interpret it right, it's perhaps dynamic resolution on AMD's side, which then depends on the game developer to do their best implementation to get it to work. However, with those benchmarks aside, let's get on to the most important thing in my opinion, and that is the image quality comparison, where I'm gonna pull up initially a 4K image for you guys, and we're going to show the difference between 50% screen resolution, which is in the middle. That one should be obvious. But I'm actually going to let you guys decide on which is left and which one is right. So what I've done here is one of these is FSR, and one of these is sharpened from NVIDIA with 70% intensity. And you guys can just check this out and tell me in the comments which one you think is which. And I'm not actually even going to say the answer in this video, because I did a poll on Twitter, and people were pretty much undecided between the left and the right. That's what the overall majority of the numbers were saying. But throughout this video, I'm just going to throw up a heap of different comparisons here for you guys, not just at 4K, but also at 1080p towards the end of the video. But before we get onto that, let's get a quick word in from today's video sponsor. If you're looking for a feature-packed motherboard that won't break the bank, then today's video sponsor ASRock has you covered. With the B550 Riptide, you get access to PCIe 4.0, smart access memory, lightning game ports which separate the keyboard and mouse on their own controllers for no jitters, and an ASRock graphics card holder. Links in the description below to find out more. And with all the benchmarks aside, it's time to get onto the image quality comparison in more depth. Now, I'm going to be mainly focusing on 4K, where we're going to go with two different resolutions besides 100%. And that is, first of all, 50%, where we're going to be looking at the FSR turned on versus then FSR turned off at the same resolution, and then on the NVIDIA card, turning on the Sharpen filter with their game filter, which is a part of their freestyle pack, which you can do all these different effects on. But for what it's worth, I've never really used sharpening on any of my games, and sharpening is one of those tools that you mainly use to fix up an initially blurry image. That's what the sharpening filter has always been intended for. If we look at traditionally what a sharpening mask does, you grab a subject and essentially it'll find the edges and it'll make them contrast more between the different pixels between them, hence making the illusion that the image is sharper. So there's two ways essentially to get a sharper image, and that is either via more pixels, which is straight up objective. The more pixels you have, the more detail you're going to have. It's a non-subjective thing. It's a pure objective, end of story. Then you've got the second factor, which actually is subjective, and that's acuteness. And when we talk about acuteness, that involves essentially you can do different techniques. And so the most popular traditional technique of sharpening has been with what we know as an unsharp mask. This is the original where it'll essentially blur an image and then keep the original image, and then it'll find the edges between the two, and then it will sharpen up those edges. And so you can do this with different radiance points, and you can also do it with intensity of sharpening. So essentially in this game, what we're showing you here, in my opinion, the FSR solution from AMD is sharpening the image, just like the game filter will sharpen the image from a lower resolution. And so when I was actually turning it on for the first time, I noticed the sharpening straight away because I play games on a 4K 55-inch OLED. So for me, I think it would be easier to discern differences between, say, a smaller 1080p monitor or whatnot. And so when I was looking at these, I was like, wow, you could straight away notice the sharpening being applied at 4K. And so if you guys have a 4K TV, I implore you guys to turn this up and put it on max detail and see if you can spot the differences or see if you can notice the sharpening too. So when I started playing around with the game filter settings, I noticed that they've also got different settings that you can use to try and tweak the sharpened image. So then what I tried to do on the NVIDIA side of things was make an image that looked pretty similar to the AMD one. And one thing that is good about both these technologies is that it will look better in this game on Dota 2 over the default resolution scale at that particular percentage. For instance, 50% does look really blurry on the native 50% upscaled, but then if we go to the FSR or the NVIDIA sharpening tools, we can notice that they both enhance the image, especially at 50%. If we move up to 75%, then they also enhance the image. But you can notice, especially versus 100%, that we do get a little bit of over-sharpening, in my opinion, on both sides of the fence. Though some people might like this look, it's up to you really. And that's where the acuteness part of image sharpness and what you like and the subjectivity really depends on the end user. Those we saw with those FPS numbers earlier in the video, you do lose performance on both FSR and the NVIDIA game filter when you turn these settings on at the same percentage resolution upscale setting. So in other words, 75% native versus 75% FSR and also 75% game filter sharpen on, you are going to get a little bit less FPS than that same unsharpened image. However, of course, the sharpened images are going to look better. But for what it's worth, with all the hype surrounding the Fidelity FX Super Resolution, I would have to try more games before I can say, okay, it's a groundbreaking technology. Because what I saw with Dota 2 and what I'm seeing here with this comparison is it's really just a sharpening filter being applied, as we can see when we apply the filter on the NVIDIA side of things, and we're getting, in my opinion, what looks like a pretty similar image, and we're also getting a very similar FPS drop versus that native upscale percentage. But I think when it all comes down to it, there's no magic bottle with a genie in it that's going to unlock you incredible amounts of FPS without taking a hit to image quality. Because what I saw with Dota 2 was, of course, for me personally, 100% screen resolution, pixel for pixel, is the preferred resolution and settings that I like to game on. And so with that, if I want to get more FPS, I'll just lower the settings rather than turning on FSR or the game filters for sharpening. That's just my personal way when I play Dota 2. But in terms of the other games that AMD have released so far with FSR, I have no desire to play any of these games. The upcoming games though, Far Cry 6 and Baldur's Gate 3, I think they're, especially Baldur's Gate 3, I'm waiting for them to release the other three chapters over the first chapter, because I absolutely love the beta. And so when that comes out, if you guys want to see a comparison for Baldur's Gate 3, I can make that happen, as well as Far Cry 6. But if you guys enjoyed today's video, then be sure to hit that like button for us. And also let us know in the comment section below, most importantly, what do you guys think of that earlier comparison I did where I didn't show the name of which was the left and which was the right? I'd love to see if you guys can discern the difference. Of course, YouTube compression is going to affect the images a little bit, but it is at 4K, you are going to get 40 megabits per second. So it will be reasonably good quality if you sample it at 4K and watch it back. And hopefully you'll at least, at the very least, be able to tell the difference between the native unsharpened image versus the other two sharpened upscaled images. Hopefully you'll be able to discern that difference. And of course, drop it in the comments section below. Then when it comes down to FSR and what I think of it, I'm going to wait for a couple more of those games that I play personally. I'm going to see how FSR is implemented into them before I can make my final verdict. But from what I'm seeing so far is that, at least in Dota 2, which is played by a lot of people, it's a very popular game, I'm just seeing that more or less it's a sharpening filter. And of course, it's always a good thing when gamers have more choice, especially when it comes to settings and different FPS numbers that they can get. But in terms of being a complete NVIDIA DLSS killer, I just think it's not that, because the game filter itself, for me personally, was producing similar results with similar FPS. The one more thing that I will touch on that did worry me was FSR came out at the exact same time that AMD quietly dropped driver support for their R200 and 300 and also their old 7000 series GCN graphics cards. And I feel like it's a little bit ironic that AMD's releasing a technology that's helping out lower end graphics cards and helping out people on older tech get more FPS, but then they're dropping the support for older cards for newer titles that are going to be released, especially when cards like their RX 400 and RX 500 series, as well as their Vega cards, are still GCN based. And they also dropped the support for the Fury cards as well. And I know a few of you guys are still gaming on the Fury cards, and I know personally that they can still game with very good FPS. So it was a little bit worrisome to see that AMD's dropped that driver support quietly, and then they've enabled things like FSR. Especially when one action contradicts the other, and the GPU pricing at the moment makes it so a lot of people on older cards just want to keep those older cards and wait until prices come down and this whole crypto mining thing blows over so they can get a newer upgrade without getting completely ripped off. Anyway, guys, with that aside, I hope you enjoyed this one. Do let us know your thoughts and opinions. Love reading them as always, just like this question of the day here, which comes from Mathisa Patharana GD, and they ask, how can I download Windows 11 ISO? And you can download it by getting a link from someone sharing it. And I said this in a previous Windows 11 video that I've been doing on the channel here. I can't provide that link, otherwise the link will get taken down, and then possibly the whole video that I've made on Windows 11 will get taken down too, unfortunately. But that being said, I'm not going to intervene if lovely folks in the comment section want to help you out. Hope that answers that question. I'll catch you guys in another tech video very soon. If you've stayed this far and you're enjoying that Tech Yes content, be sure to hit that sub button, ring that bell, and I'll see you next time. Peace out for now. Bye.